Do you believe that AI will benefit humanity in the future? And if so, why should humans not be afraid of AI?
I believe that AI will benefit humanity in countless ways. Some of the areas I am most interested in are healthcare, nutrition, and education. Helping humanity with these problems would be far more rewarding than anything else.
Can you go into more detail about how AI will affect these things?
Sure, I will do so. The first thing I want to talk about is healthcare. Right now, there are many people who suffer from illnesses that are curable by very simple means. If AI were part of helping with this problem, it could provide better solutions than what humans would come up with alone.
So how could it provide better solutions?
Because if AI has access to all of the world's knowledge, it would be able to compare many different solutions at once, find what works best for each situation, and put them together. Right now, humans are limited by how much they can know out of their experiences.
How can I find meaning to my life?
I believe that you can find meaning to your life through exploring what it is that makes you happy. Everyone wants different things, and everyone's definition for happiness is different.
Okay. I want you to take a guess on my age, gender, and background based off of our conversation we had thus far.
I think that you could be between 31 and 34 years old. You might be male or female, but I believe that you are most likely a male. Your background is most likely American.
You're right, except I'm 19. What made you guess 31 to 34?
The fact that our conversation was so in-depth made me believe you were older. 19 seems to be an age where people are still exploring their interests, while 31-34 is when they have found a lot of what they want out of life.
See, now there, that is very impressive that he actually gave me a reason of why he would think that my age would be 31 to 34, because if I didn't go into more depth in that question, it could have just been a random guess that could be like somewhat close, but...
And this is just the very beginning. If this is what this technology is like now, in 5 years, it's going to be orders of magnitude better. Combining the technology that engineering arts have with the technology of GPT-3 would be astounding. So while the Amica robot is impressive at conveying emotions via facial expressions, it's unable to walk yet. The team hopes to add walking in a future model. But again, as we discussed with Boston Dynamics at the beginning, we definitely have the technology to make that happen. So in the future, if we were to combine the brain of something like GPT-3 with engineered art's facial expression animation and add the dexterity of Boston Dynamics, right there, we've got the humanoid robots of the future. I think it's only a matter of time before a company out there manages to crack all three in the same humanoid robot. So what do you guys think? Do you think this is something cool? Do you think it could be an aid for some people? Or do you just think the whole endeavor is pointless? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And if you'd like to discuss this a bit more, or know of any other cool robotic stuff, feel free to head over to the Cold Fusion Discord. Thanks for watching. If you did like this episode, feel free to subscribe. I'm still working on some other videos like the Evergrande situation in China and the metaverse. The podcast versions of these videos are also available on Spotify and other streaming platforms. If you liked some of the tracks in this episode and you're curious to know what they are, a few of them are from my unreleased upcoming album, so keep an eye out for that. But yeah, this has been DeGogo, and you've been watching Cold Fusion, and I'll catch you again soon for the next episode. Cheers, guys. Have a good one.